High glory to God. Have you ever asked yourself, how am I supposed to make my day great? You know what? This Pastor Peter Ashers over this morning bringing God's word to you and showing you from God's word how to make your day great. Glory to God. This morning I'll be sharing from the book of Luke chapter number 10 verse 19 and 20. And it reads, I'll be using the Amplified version. It said, behold, I have given you authority and power to trample upon serpents and scorpions and physical and mental strength and ability over all the power of the enemy, over all the power that the enemy possesses, and nothing shall in any way harm you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice at this that the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice that your names are enrolled in heaven. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me actually take verse 21 also. And it reads, it said, in that same hour, he rejoiced and glorified the Holy Spirit and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have concealed these things relating to salvation from the wise and understanding and learned, and revealed them to babes, the childish, unskilled, and untaught. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will and choice and good pleasure. Glory to God. So this scripture is letting us know something really fundamental about our faith in God. You know, as you woke up this morning, you're going about your day to understand the word of God and how to walk it. Yes, because as God's people, we need to be trained in how to walk the word, how to put the word of God to work in our lives and see it produce results. And Jesus, in this instant, was also teaching his disciples how to put the word of God to work. He had sent them out and to preach the gospel to preach the gospel, and they came back rejoicing, you know, like really, really excited, super excited. That what they've seen Jesus doing, they put it to work. They went out preaching the gospel and they cast out devils. The spirits were subject to them. They saw Satan and his agents, you know, fleeing as they put the word of God to work. And they commanded devils out, and they saw miracles, obviously. And they came back, you know, rejoicing, excited that the Lord had performed great things through them. And you know what? As they came back rejoicing, announcing the good news to Jesus, of course, letting them know how they've taken authority over demonic spirit, Jesus said unto them, do not rejoice because the spirit were subject to you. Do not rejoice. He said, For even actually in verse 18, he said, I saw Satan fall like lightning, which means from heaven, which means Jesus saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. He was telling these kids in the things of God, children in the things of God, that relax. You've just seen the beginning. You just seen the beginning. You saw a spirit. You saw demon spirit fleeing. I saw Satan fall like lightning, letting them know that the power that they possess, the power they've been given, is that same power that caused Satan to fall from heaven as lightning. Hallelujah. You know what this tells us? This lets us know, as God's people, the moment and time, the day and moment we gave our lives and heart to Christ, the day and moment that we make Jesus the Lord of our lives, there is great deposit of power that's been released into us. We've been given authority. We are not beggars in this world. Hallelujah. We have authority over the beggarly elements. That's what we call them. The beggarly elements of the devil and his agents in the world. Hallelujah. Though we are in the world, we are not of the world. Why? Because we operate from a higher dimension. Hallelujah. So in verse 19, Jesus said unto the disciples, he said, behold, I give unto you authority and power. Hallelujah. Authority means delegated power. So we've been given delegated power. The moment and time we got born again, we've been given delegated power. Hallelujah. And you know what? This is not meant only for pastors. This is not meant only for prophets. This is not meant only for apostles. This is not meant only for those who are, you know, some people consider super spiritual or super gifted. No, this is meant for every true born again child of God. Hallelujah. If you study this scripture we just read properly, you see that as Jesus went down in speaking to them, and in verse 21, he said, "Father, I thank you that you've hidden these things from the learned and the wise and the understanding, those who are educated, basically meant, but you've revealed them to babes and those who are unskilled and untaught." That's what he said in the Amplified Version. So this lets us know that at that stage, the disciples were still unskilled. They were still untaught. They were still babes in the things of the Spirit. But yet, they just finished casting out devils. They just finished putting devil and his agents to flight. And Jesus is referring to them here as babes. As untaught, as kids in the things of the Spirit. Hallelujah. You know what this tells me? This should be an encouragement to you this morning. It doesn't matter how you feel. It doesn't matter how the situation that faces you or the condition that you face right now as you go about your day to day. It doesn't matter the level that you are in the things of the Spirit. Yes, there are levels, obviously, in the things of God. There are those who are babes, who are just coming into Christ. Maybe they just gave their life to Christ, maybe today or yesterday. But you know what? With God, it doesn't matter. As long as you're a child of God, whether you just gave your heart to Christ in the last 2 minutes ago, it doesn't count. Automatically, you could take on the word of God and put it to work and see results and see devils fleeing. Hallelujah. You've been given authority. In verse 19, he said, "Behold, I give unto you authority to trample upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemies." And he said, "Nothing shall by no means hurt you." So we've been given, you know, this delegated power to trample upon serpents and scorpions. What are serpents? Serpents are refers to the devil and his demonic spirits. Scorpions refer to demon spirits that afflicts people. Hallelujah. That afflicts people. You know what? This morning I was just meditating, and the Lord just reminded me about an incident that took place in our home many years ago. And you know what? I respect my dad so much. I've learned a whole lot from him. And because he's a man given to prayers, a man of prayers, and who has been used mightily of God in many instances. And on this occasion, it was night, and we were woken up from sleep by my dad, and we needed to pray. And we got into the room, my mommy's room, and we had our last born was still a kid then, and just placed on the was on the bed. And on the bed where he lay, there's this little mat for babies that are placed under, just to protect them from wetting the bed and all of that, to protect the bed. And it's like during the night, my mom sensed that the baby was like not at rest, like really, really getting uncomfortable. And she thought, okay, maybe the baby wet the bed and is uncomfortable in the pee. And she raised the mat in order like to feel and to know whether he wet the bed. And all of a sudden, what she saw was flames of fire. I'm not talking about a spiritual issue now. This one is, it was in the physical. And she saw flames as she raised the mat under the baby to see what was, whether he peed on the bed. She saw flames under the baby. Obviously, the baby was being, you know, the enemy was trying to just cook the baby alive. Hallelujah. And, you know, there are people who don't believe in these things, but it happens. And I went into that room that day as we all came out to the room and we started praying. My dad woke us up and we all went into the room and started praying. And my dad rose that stuff up again. I saw that flame with my physical eyes. So that flame, the devil and his agents, were practically, they practically set a fire under that baby. And you know, this speaks to the fact that parents need to be spiritual. Parents need to be, you know, strong in prayer. Sometimes people wake up and they find their children, the temperature of their children hot, and they feel, oh, maybe it's just a common fever, maybe it's just this, maybe it's just that. Well, I'm not disputing that there could be common fever and all of that, but sometimes the devil might have set fire under their bodies during the night. And this, I saw him with my optical eyes. As my dad raised up the mat again, I saw that flame. And we started praying and prayed and prayed and prayed. We prayed the whole lot that night. And that flame was extinguished. It was extinguished and quenched, hallelujah, by the power of God's Spirit and by the fact that we put the word of God to work that day, and we put the devil and his agents where they belong, hallelujah. And and that little baby is a grown-up man right now and doing well, very well. You know what am I trying to say? This speaks to the fact that we've been given authority. We are not supposed to be ignorant believers. We are not supposed to be ignorant Christians. We are supposed to take on the authority that we've been given and put it to work in our lives, in our homes. You know what? This can save a life. This can put you over in life if you are able to get a hold of this revelation this morning. The Spirit of God said in the scripture, the Lord Jesus was saying, he said, behold, behold, behold. That word means see, I have given unto you. Hallelujah. There are some persons probably right now listening to me. You've not been seeing this. All you've been seeing is the trouble. All you've been seeing is what the devil has been doing. All you've been seeing is how many challenges you are facing. All you've been seeing is, the wicked acts of the enemy around you, around your family, in your head. But you know what? It is time. If you are a believer, if you are born again, this is time to see what God has given you, the power, the immense power that has been deposited in your life. Hallelujah. This is the immense time to put it to work. As you go out today, as you do what you do, you rise by the power of the Spirit, because you are not ordinary. As a child of God, you carry power, you carry authority, hallelujah. So step into that office. Yes, you say, oh, pastor, but I'm only a little Christian, I don't know much. No, you don't necessarily need to be a pastor. All you need to do, just believe. You just act in childlike faith, like these disciples. They went out under the instructions of Jesus to preach the gospel in childlike faith, and they put the devil and his agents to flight. Hallelujah. He said, behold, I give unto you authority to trample upon serpents and scorpions, and over not some but all the powers of the enemies. Hallelujah. I like that part. All of the powers of the enemies. Hallelujah. The Lord has given me power over all the powers of the enemy. He has given me power, authority over all the abilities of the enemies. That's how the Amplified put it. Over all their abilities. All their abilities. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This gives me, boldness to face my day. Hallelujah. And this is how to have a great day. So as you step out today, you speak to that job, you speak to that business, you speak to your academics, you speak to your body, you speak to your family. Hallelujah. You speak to your finances. You take over, you take authority over that devil that's trying to run riot in your body, that's trying to run riot in your family, that's trying to run riot in your job or your business or in your academics. That devil that's trying to run riot in those things that are dear to you or in the life of your children. You know what? You take authority. Hallelujah. Because that authority has been given to you by Jesus. He said, behold, see into this, that I have given you authority, delegated power. Hallelujah. Delegated power to trample upon serpents and scorpions. Hallelujah. And over all the powers of the enemies, and nothing shall by no means hurt you. I pray for you today. You that's been troubled by demonic spirit, you that's been troubled by oppression of Satan, I rebuke that devil from your life. I rebuke that devil from your body. I rebuke that demon spirit from your home in the name of Jesus. You who's been troubled in your head, I rebuke that sickness by the power of the Holy Spirit. spirit, from your body, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I speak health. I speak life. I speak strength to your body. Be healed right now. In the name of Jesus, begin to do what you could not do before. If you could not rise on your feet before, I declare in the name of Jesus, rise right on your feet right now. Stand right on your feet in the name of Jesus. If you could not move any part of your body before, maybe your hands or your feet or your neck, begin to move it now in the name of Jesus. The power of the Holy Spirit is upon you right now. I rebuke that pain. I rebuke that infirmity from your body in the name of Jesus. If it's your little child or a baby that was sick around you, you just lay the hand upon that baby, and I declare in the name of Jesus, you child of God, be healed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I declare that every fiber of your body, every bone of your body receives strength and receive healing right now in the name of Jesus. I declare peace upon your home. Yes, you who has been depressed for a while, I declare that depression, that spirit of darkness that have settled upon your life, I command that spirit to leave you now. Hope has come in you. Yes, hope is born in you. Hallelujah. The light of God shines into your life. Hallelujah. And you begin to see possibilities in your life. Yes, there's a future ahead of you. Hallelujah. Receive light. Hallelujah. Receive light. And receive peace in your heart. Hallelujah. Mantoko sheketaya. Ribaba de brondosha. Da bredo zote kikataya rabos. De brakatosh kede arabos. Ne baba ba sonda. Nando sheke katarago sukoya. I declare right now that in the name of Jesus, you have problems in your eyes. There's one who is listening and you have issues with your eyes. Just place your right hand on those eyes. I declare those eyes receive sight now. In the name of Jesus, your sight is restored. In the name of Jesus. And for you who is not yet born again, maybe all these that we've just spoken about, you don't know much about them. You say, oh, I don't really understand all the spiritual matters that Pastor has been talking about. You know what? You know what? Where you need to start from is to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. And this same authority that we spoke of this morning, this authority will be yours. Authority to live triumphantly in life and to live as a victor, as a master over the elements of the world. You could walk and live in that authority. Hallelujah. And the way to go is to confess the Lordship of Jesus. The scripture tells us in Romans chapter 10 from 8 to 10. It says, if thou shalt confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Christ from the dead, he said, thou shalt be saved. The scripture also tells us in Acts of the Apostles 2:21. He said, whosoever, take note of that word, whosoever, you can be that whosoever today. He said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Hallelujah. So you can call upon the name of the Lord this morning. You can declare with your mouth. Hallelujah. So you make this prayer after me, believing it in your heart, and you know what? Salvation will be yours. So you declare, Father, in the name of Jesus, I've come to you. Just as I am a sinner, I heard your word and I believe that you send your son Jesus Christ as the perfect sacrifice for my sin. And today I believe that he died, was buried, and on the third day rose again for my justification. And today I declare that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life. I'm no longer under the devil and his kingdom. I've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God's dear son. And if you made that prayer from the depth of your heart, you are born again. Welcome to the family of God. I want you to look out for a Bible-believing church in the city where you live. Join that church so that you'll be groomed up and trained in the things of God. And if peradventure you live anywhere in Padua, that's the name in English, but in Italian, Padova. If you live around Padua and or in any of the adjoining cities, like Vicenza, Rovigo, Ferrara, Mestre, even Bologna or Treviso, I want to invite you to come worship with us at Healing Grace Christian Assembly, Via J Avanzo. That's the name of the address, number 17, just behind the Padova train station. Exactly. As soon as you come out from the underground tunnel, towards the Arcella direction, the building you find where you have the police, Policia Locale located, we are just beside them. You find a yellow doorpost. You walk right into that door to the first floor, and we are right there. By 10 a.m. on Sunday morning, we have our Sunday schools, and by 11, we have the men's service on Tuesdays, and it starts by 6:30 in the evening to 8 p.m. So we'll be waiting for you. We want to pray with you. We want to encourage you with God's word and want to help you become all that God has called you to be. Hallelujah. Because God have great things in stock for you. And I want you to do something good this morning. Help your friends and loved ones to start off with a good day by sharing this message with at least 10 of your loved ones. Share with them so that they too can have a great day. And if you've not subscribed on our YouTube channel, ensure to find out Pastor Peter Ashazob on YouTube and subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that when next we post new videos, because we do that every day, video and audio format messages we do every day, you will be one of the first to receive the message and be blessed by it. And more so, we have so much resource on that channel that will bless you. God bless you. And I want to wish you have a great day. God bless you.